Lately, the ranking system for the new Trackmania has been revealed. Since quite a few people were kinda confused about how the ranking system is going to work, I'm going to try to give you a small explanation. So, first of all, it's important to mention that basically everything you do in the game will help you to climb up in the rankings. But how is this going to work? For every activity in the game, you get so-called trophies. Overall, there are 9 different trophies, and each trophy gives you a certain amount of points. Each of these trophies will earn you 10 times more points than the lower trophy. So for example, the first trophy is going to give you 1 point, the second trophy is going to give you 10 points, and the third trophy already earns you 100 points. This goes all the way up to the 9th trophy, which actually gives you 100 million points. This trophy 9 is the most valuable trophy in the whole ranking system, and it's only given away to winners of very big competitions, for example the Trackmania Grand League, the Open Grand League, and the ZRT Trackmania Cup. Also, the winner of each seasonal campaign will receive one trophy 9. So basically, for every competition in the game and for every track you're going to play, you're gonna get a certain amount of trophies. But obviously, you're not only going to receive points for winning big competitions. Just as an example, imagine you're getting 4th place at the Open Grand League, which still is a really good result. You're maybe gonna get like 4 times Trophy 8, which would also equal 40 million points. But this is just an example, because right now we don't know what the exact point repetition is going to look like. But you are not only getting points for playing big competitions like the ZRT Trackmania Cup or the Trackmania Grand League. You can also receive points by playing the official campaigns by Nadeo, for example the seasonal campaign. Furthermore, you will also be able to earn trophies by playing tracks online. For example, if you are hunting a track online that already a lot of other people played as well, you are gonna receive more points for a first Dedimania record than for a track which has only been played by like 10 players. So as I already said, each trophy is going to give you a certain amount of points. And exactly on those points the overall ranking system is based. So overall there are 10 different categories in the ranking system. The best one basically is called World 1, and it goes all the way down to unranked. This whole ranking system is going to last for exactly 1 year. And after this 1 year, the points of every player are going to get reset. Since the amount of points you are going to receive for each trophy increases exponentially, it's not going to be possible to just farm points by doing like small activities, for example getting world records on tracks that barely anyone plays. In order to get a good rank with this ranking system, it's necessary to get good results in big competitions. So the strategy with the new ranking system is going to be to play much, but most importantly, it is important to play big cups and to get good results there, since those are getting rewarded the most. Another interesting fact to mention is something what Hylas said in an interview with Eirik Holder. He said that after the actual release of the game, there's going to be a system implemented into the game which will allow players to decide by their own what competitions are worth bigger trophies and which competitions aren't. So far, we have no idea how the system is going to work, we just know that this system is going to exist at some point. In case you still have any questions about the new ranking system, let me know in the comments and I'm going to try to answer it as good as possible.